I will show you how you can step up the overall performance of your device. If you haven't watched my previous video on how to download and install Nox Player on your PC, then please watch it first. So, let's begin without any delay. First of all, access the settings menu from this settings icon located at the top right part of Nox Player emulator. Inside settings, we have 8 different options. But we only have to change 5 of them. The first settings we have to change is inside this general tab. Uncheck this launch on startup option because when the system starts, the Nox Player also starts along with the system. And for low-end PCs, it's really hard to load the system file along with these emulator files. Now let's move to performance settings. The first option is performance settings. Here, allocate the 2-core CPU because the minimum requirement to run the Nox Player is at least dual-core CPU, which means you already have 2 cores. Inside the graphics rendering mode, you will find DirectX and OpenGL. I would suggest you try OpenGL at first, and if it doesn't seem to work, change it to DirectX. Because some CPUs are more compatible with DirectX and some are more with OpenGL. And the compatibility of graphics with renderers are the same as CPU. Inside the resolution settings, choose mobile phone from the drop-down menu and set the resolution to 540 by 960. After this, let's skip interface settings and sound settings and then move to game settings directly. The first option is frame rate. In the case of frame rate, the higher the better. But if we look at performance, the higher frame rate requires higher specs as well. So let's keep it at 30 only. The mouse acceleration and zoom scope are optional. Leave them as they are. The ASTC texture is also very helpful for smooth gaming. If you want clear graphics, select Open ASTC texture, which will improve graphics. And if you want a higher frame rate, then check mark on Enable Rendering Cache. Now let's move to phone model and internet settings. First of all, click on this drop-down and select Asus ROG 2 because the Asus ROG 2 is the best gaming smartphone in the market. After you have changed all the settings, click on Save Settings and click Restart Now on the pop-up. These are the settings from Nox Player only. Now we are going to change settings from our system. The first thing we have to do is we have to change default graphics settings and set it to best performance. To do so, go to Start and search for settings. Inside settings, choose Display. Then scroll down and select Graphics. Now, under Custom option for the App section, choose Desktop App. Then click Browse. Now follow me carefully. Navigate to your C drive, then click on Program Files. After that, open the Nox folder. Inside Nox, go to the Bin folder. Now scroll down and select Nox or Nox.exe. After that, click on Nox and select Options. Inside the pop-up, choose High Performance and click Save. Now close the settings. After this, let's change Power option to Performance mode. So go to Start and search for the Control Panel. Select Hardware and Sounds. Go to Power options. Now, you might have an option called Performance, choose it. And if you want to create your own power plan, click on Create a Power Plan. Then select High Performance. Under the Name section, write High Performance and click Next. Finally, click on Create. Now, after setting the high performance power plan, close the control panel. Now let's enable game mode. Go to Start and search for settings. Open settings. go to Gaming and click on Game Mode. Then enable Game Mode from here. Finally, the most important setting we have to set is Priority. Press Ctrl Shift plus Escape at once and Task Manager will open up. From there, go to Details tab. Go to Nox.exe and right click on it. Hover over Set Priority and select Priority to High. Do this just before playing a game. If you do this at first, then your system will lag. These settings will utilize your PC's resource mostly to Nox player, and you have to do this process every time. These are the major settings you have to change in order to get more FPS and improve performance. In the upcoming videos, I will find new tricks and methods to improve performance of your device. Till then, stay tuned. I hope this tutorial was helpful for you. If it works, let me know either by hitting the like button or even by writing a comment. Plus, let's hit the target of 10 likes in this video. Finally, if you like this tutorial, then subscribe to my channel for more useful videos like this. And this is much for today, guys. See you in the next video.